My name is Paul Hardiman and I'm a clinical academic at University College. I work in the Institute for Women's Health. So I'm an NHS consultant and I see patients with hormone conditions related to reproduction and also fertility problems. And I see them in my clinics at University College Hospital, the Whittington Hospital and the Royal Free Hospital, all in London. I lead a research team consisting of academics, doctors, scientists, nurses and midwives who are researching hormone disorders in women, and particularly a condition called polycystic ovary syndrome. So what is polycystic ovary syndrome? Well, it's one of the commonest hormone disorders to affect the human and affects between 10 and 15% of all women. So there's about 1 million women in the UK with this condition. It's the commonest cause of infertility, which arises from the failure of ovulation. And it's also the commonest cause of androgen excess, that's to say too much male hormone in women. Women have male hormone like men, just less of it. And if they have too much, they can get conditions like acne or excess or unwanted body hair. In the past, this has been considered a relatively mild or niche condition, but in fact, it causes huge distress for women. They have lower levels of self-esteem, they feel less feminine, and they have more anxiety and more depression. In fact, the symptoms aren't only related to short-term problems, but in the longer term, we now know women with polycystic ovary syndrome are more likely to get type 2 diabetes, more likely to have coronary heart disease, that's a heart attack, more likely to have a stroke, and more likely to get cancer of the lining of the womb. So far from being a trivial condition, this is a condition which causes immense distress and actually places a huge economic burden on the NHS. One of the areas of polycystic ovary syndrome which has been less researched but is now becoming more recognised is the effect on the baby and the mother if a woman with this condition gets pregnant. There's data from animal studies that shows that if you give the pregnant animal an injection of a male hormone of testosterone, the offspring are more likely to get diabetes or heart disease in later life. This is also thought to be one of the ways in which polycystic ovary syndrome is transmitted from one generation to the next. So my research has focused on this transgenerational effect of PCOS. We're looking at the growth and behaviour and hormones of babies born mothers with polycystic ovary syndrome. Our most important finding is that we were the first to show that babies whose mothers have polycystic ovary syndrome are exposed to increased levels of male hormone before they're even born. And this could have important effects on their health. We're currently carrying out a study, the first of its type, to look at the effect of polycystic ovary syndrome on mothers during pregnancy and on their babies. So we're recruiting women during pregnancy and also women who don't have polycystic ovary syndrome, and comparing the complications during pregnancy and the effects on their babies. So we weigh and measure the babies at birth and check their hormone levels. And then we do the same thing on the babies when they're 9 months old and when they're 15 months old. And our aim is to find out the effects of having polycystic ovary syndrome mother on your baby. We think that's important because if there is an effect, and if it's detrimental, we could then offer the mother relatively simple treatment to try and offset those complications.